So this is the actual immunity charm which we developed. So this has three components. The first are these black beads, which are the part of the tradition which the kids wear. There is an evil eye in between, which is supposed to be the core, which protects from evil energies. And then we added these colored beads to it. Each bead signifies a vaccine dose, which is given to the child. So every time the child gets immunized, the doctor adds the corresponding bead to it. And this actually becomes like a vaccination card. It's such a strong superstition that kids in India, South, and actually the whole of South Asia are made to wear a bracelet from the day they are born, and it is meant to protect them from evil spirits. And the tradition is so strong, even in the educated communities, that I was following it to the core. So I think there were three key factors that led to the success and relevance of this initiative. First was, it was simple. It was extremely simple, no high-tech science or anything involved, and it was very easy to communicate to everyone. I think the second one was the cultural relevance of this idea, because the tradition was such strongly rooted in culture, we didn't get any backlash from any communities in any part. And that made to increased acceptance of this initiative. And it is said that if an idea is strongly rooted in culture, the behavior change happens quickly, and no amount of media can actually match that. And third, which is a very interesting one, is especially with the healthcare professionals. Healthcare professionals are usually loaded with a lot of initiatives for data tracking, which are mainly apps or filling out report cards or mainly awareness initiatives. But I think what we found out was what was lacking is something neural. If there is something which you can touch and feel, you actually like to do that. And that was actually something interesting which I heard at one of the sessions that happens at CANS just about an hour ago. And I think that was a reason for success of this initiative. So for physicians, we had created a training video which was delivered through Skype by our medical team, and the video was used like a train the trainer program which they could use to extend to rest of the physicians. Also, we had created printed communication for them which acted like a ready reckoner, and it was also a part of the kit which they used to put on immunity charm to kids. There is a trend which is more technologically oriented. I saw so many ideas, actually most of them using a lot of technology. And to me, it's kind of complicating things a bit because it reduces the scalability of any initiative. And when we are looking at solving big public health problems, I think scalability has to be at the core of it. And when it comes to kids, I would be wary of exposing them to radiations or waves or different kind of technologies. Although there is no science or papers to prove that, but it would still be a question. I think ideas which are simple make a long-lasting difference. That's what we strongly believe in.